Vijay Kevlani, Assistant Professor, LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Welcome to a MOOC series, an initiative taken by LJ Institute of Pharmacy. In today's session, we will talk about hepatitis and its pathophysiology. So, hepatitis is a broad term that means inflammation of liver. It is most commonly caused by virus, but also it can be caused by drugs, chemicals, autoimmune diseases, and metabolic abnormalities. The etiology of hepatitis, it includes viral hepatitis, alcoholic hepatitis, autoimmune hepatitis, and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. So, liver inflammation can be due to virus, it can be due to alcohol, it can be due to autoimmune disease, or it can be due to fat accumulation on the surface of liver. So, what we are going to discuss is viral hepatitis. Viral hepatitis is further classified into 5 types: hepatitis A, B, C, D, and E. These classes are given based on the type of virus present in that condition. So, in viral hepatitis, 5 types of hepatitis have been identified: hepatitis A, B, C, D, and E. D, hepatitis D, is actually known as delta hepatitis. Hepatitis A is always an acute short-term disease, while hepatitis B, C, and D are most likely to become ongoing and chronic. Hepatitis E is usually acute but can be particularly dangerous in pregnant women, and hepatitis A and E viruses typically cause only acute or short-term infection. Other less common viruses can also cause liver disease, and this includes cytomegalovirus, herpes virus, rubella virus, and Epstein-Barr virus. Incidence. So, viral hepatitis is a major public health concern. 10 million cases occur worldwide. It is nearly universal during childhood in developing countries. India is a hyperendemic for hepatitis A virus infection. Annually, over 1 to 2 lakh Indians die due to illness related to hepatitis B virus infection. Worldwide, 170 million people are infected with hepatitis C. Talking about hepatitis A, so a highly contagious liver infection caused by the hepatitis A virus. Hepatitis A virus is ribonucleic acid virus of enterovirus family. It can cause acute hepatitis with jaundice, also cause acute liver failure. It does not cause long-term infection. Incubation period is 3 to 5 weeks with an average of 28 days. It is transmitted primarily through fecal-oral route. Sources of infection is crowded condition, poor personal hygiene, poor sanitization, contaminated food, water, shellfish, person with subclinical infection, and infected food handlers. More prevalent in underdeveloped countries. People who travel to developing countries more likely to get hepatitis A virus. Signs and symptoms are fatigue, fever, abdominal pain, nausea, jaundice, weight loss, itching, sharp pain in right upper quadrant of abdomen, and anorexia. A diagnosis, so it can be diagnosed by blood test. So, 2 immunoglobulins, immunoglobulin M and immunoglobulin G are identified. Immunoglobulin M antibodies show acute infection. Immunoglobulin G antibodies show previous infection or immunization. Management, so there are no drug therapies for the treatment of acute hepatitis A. Rest according to patient's level of fatigue. Hospitalization sometimes required. Small frequent feedings of a high calorie, low fat diet. Proteins are restricted. Vitamin K injection if PT is prolonged, and IV fluid and electrolyte replacement. Antiemetic drugs are given to prevent vomiting. Next is hepatitis B. So hepatitis B virus can cause acute and chronic infection. Acute hepatitis B infection may last up to 6 months, and infected persons are able to pass this virus during this time. Chronic hepatitis B is defined as persistence of hepatitis B surface antigen for 6 months or more after acute infection with hepatitis B virus. Incubation period is 2 to 5 months. Hepatitis B virus is complex structure with 3 distinct antigens: hepatitis B core antigen, hepatitis B surface antigen, and an independent protein circulating in the blood, that is hepatitis B E antigen. Mode of transmission is mainly sexual contact, recognized as STD, that is sexual transmitted disease. It is much more infectious than HIV. Signs and symptoms are abdominal pain, dark urine, fever, joint pain, loss of appetite, nausea or vomiting, fatigue, and jaundice. Diagnosis, so by blood test, AST, ALT, ALP, GGT, serum protein, prothrombin time, urine bilirubin, urinary urobilinogen, and total serum bilirubin. Serological testing, so the antigens like surface antigen or anti-HBs or HBe antigen or anti-hepatitis B E, that is E antigen, against the hepatitis B antigen, and anti-HBe immunoglobulin M, right, immunoglobulin G, hepatitis B virus genotype. Then after liver ultrasound, so transient elastography can show the amount of liver damage. Liver biopsy and fibro test. Management. So treatment of acute hepatitis B is indicated only in patients with severe hepatitis and liver failure. Rest vitamin supplements and avoid alcohol. Treatment of chronic hepatitis B. So nucleoside and nucleotide analogs such as tenofovir, adenofovir, and lamivudine. Interferon, standard interferon, pegylated interferon, and liver transplant. Hepatitis C virus. So hepatitis C virus is an RNA virus. Incubation period is 14 to 180 days. In most cases, it is transmitted through blood or transmitted through unprotected sex and also contaminated or unsterile needles. It is found in IV drug users and renal dialysis patients. It can result in both acute and chronic illness. Chronic hepatitis C virus infection results in liver cirrhosis, and there is no vaccines for hepatitis C virus. Diagnosis, so hepatitis C antibody and hepatitis C virus genotyping. Management, so in patient with acute hepatitis C, treatment with pegylated interferon with 12 to 24 weeks of infection reduce the development of chronic hepatitis C. Chronic hepatitis C virus can be treated with pegylated interferon, ribavirin, ribitol, and protease inhibitors. Hepatitis D or delta hepatitis. So hepatitis D or delta hepatitis is a defective single-strand RNA virus that cannot survive on its own. It requires hepatitis B to replicate. Incubation period is 2 to 26 weeks. Chronic carriers of hepatitis B virus always at risk for transmission. Source of infections are same as hepatitis B virus, that is contaminated food or contaminated place or asymptomatic subjects. Hepatitis D virus infection is only possible if a person is already infected with hepatitis B, as hepatitis D requires hepatitis B for replication. Diagnosis, so anti-hepatitis D virus and hepatitis D virus antigen. Treatment, it is treated by interferon. Next is hepatitis E. So hepatitis E virus is an RNA virus and incubation period is 15 to 64 days. Hepatitis E virus has a fecal oral transmission route. Sources of infection is contaminated water, poor sanitization, found in Asia, Africa, and Mexico. More common in adults and severe in pregnant women. Hepatitis E usually resolves on its own within 4 to 6 weeks. Treatment focuses on supportive care and rehydration and reset. Diagnosis, so anti-hepatitis E virus immunoglobulin M and immunoglobulin G. hepatitis E virus RNA quantification. Treatment, so there is no specific treatment capable of altering the courses of acute hepatitis E. As the disease is usually self-limiting, hospitalization is generally not required. Hospitalization is required for people with fulminant hepatitis. Pathophysiology of hepatitis. So during an acute hepatitis, liver damage is mediated by cytotoxic cytokines and natural killer cells. Creatinine kinase and cytokines cause lysis of infected hepatocytes and it leads to cholestasis. Liver cells can regenerate after acute infection. A chronic viral infection causes chronic inflammation and causes fibrosis over decade, and this fibrosis will develop into the cirrhotic condition. Clinical manifestation. So clinical manifestation of viral hepatitis are classified into acute and chronic phase. Manifestations of acute hepatitis are as follows, which symptoms are similar to mild flu. So these are anorexia, nausea, vomiting, constipation or diarrhea, right upper quadrant discomfort, malaise, fever, headache, arthralgia, urticaria, hepatomegaly, splenomegaly, weight loss, jaundice, dark urine, light stool, decreased sense of smell or taste, and bilirubinemia. Chronic hepatitis shows malaise, easy fatigability, hepatomegaly, myalgia, and elevated liver enzymes. Complications of hepatitis, viral hepatitis, are dehydration, hypokalemia, chronic carrier hepatitis, cholestatic hepatitis, fulminant hepatitis, liver cirrhosis, and hepatocellular carcinoma. Frequently asked questions from this point are references. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel PharmaIgnite for more videos. Thank you.